Good afternoon students, welcome to online bridge course 2020. Let me introduce myself. I am Chidanand Kachnur, working as a lecturer in mathematics at Oxford Partils PU Science College, Nagarbatta. So recently you have completed your SSLC annual examination and hoping for a better results. So your annual exam result will be announced in the first week of the August. Till then, it is time for you to relax at home and make your basics very strong. So for that, to make science more easy and interesting, our college management has introduced this particular course. So now coming back to the subject, so in today's class I am going to start with the number systems and then classification of the number systems. Well, let us start with the number systems. So the number systems can be defined as the collection of numbers. So here we are going to divide real numbers into two types, that is rational numbers and irrational numbers. See here, real numbers can be classified into two types. So here it is, rational numbers and irrational numbers. So what is the real number here? So a real number is the set of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So then we'll discuss about, and we represent the real numbers by capital R, and then we'll discuss about the rational numbers and irrational numbers. Well, let us write the definition of real numbers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. See here, the real numbers are the combination of rational and irrational numbers in the number system. The number system, and it is denoted by capital R. So now the real numbers are divided into two types, rational and irrational. Types of real numbers. Types of real numbers. So in that we have rational numbers rational numbers. So what are rational numbers? Now the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q are called rational numbers, where P and Q are the integers and Q should not be equal to 0. See here, the numbers which can be written in the form of which can be written in the form of P by Q, in the form of P by Q, then where Q not equal to 0, the denominator should not be equal to 0. In case if it is 0, it is not defined, and P comma Q belongs to Z, that is both are the integers, then it is denoted by, it is, that is the rational numbers are denoted by, it is denoted by, it is denoted by capital Q. Next we'll go for the definition of irrational numbers. So we'll give an example for this. Example, it is 2 by 3, and then 5 by 9, and so on. These are the examples. And then next we'll go for irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. So what is the definition of an irrational number? So the numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. The example, it is root 2, root 3, root 5, and so on. Such numbers are called irrational numbers. The numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q, in the form of P by Q, are called irrational numbers. And here for irrational numbers, there is no standard notation to represent it. So now the example for irrational numbers, it is root 2 and then root 3, then root 5, and so on. So this is all about a rational number and irrational numbers. Well, the rational numbers are classified into natural numbers, whole numbers, and then integers. So see here, first we'll go for the natural numbers. Natural numbers. Natural numbers. Then we'll see the definition now. So numbers starting from 1. Numbers starting from one, which we use for counting the objects. Numbers starting from 1, which we use for counting the numbers, are called natural numbers. It is denoted by, it is denoted by capital N. See here, that is N which is equals to 1. So it starts from 1, not from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So this is the set of natural numbers. Swabhavika sankhyagalu anta kannadadalli helutive. Next type it is whole numbers. Whole numbers. Whole numbers. The numbers starting from 0 and all the natural numbers and all the natural numbers are called whole numbers So here the numbers starting from 0 including the natural numbers. So we can write it as including the natural numbers are called whole numbers. And here the whole numbers are represented by, it is denoted by W, that is W, which is equals to, it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, and it continues. So this is all about the whole numbers. Well, next we are going to discuss about integers. What is the definition of an integer? The collection of all negative and positive numbers including 0 are called integers, and usually integers are denoted by Z, that is the capital letter Z. See here, the collection of positive and negative, negative numbers including 0, including 0 are called integers. And so integers are denoted by capital Z. So here it is denoted by, Z. So sometimes they use Z plus and Z minus, that means set of positive integers and set of negative integers. See here, that is Z, which is equals to minus 2, minus 1, 0, and then 1, 2, 3, and so on. So this is the set of integers. So now I go for set of positive integers and set of negative integers. See here, set of positive integers. So this is represented by Z plus, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so on. Here we have not included zero because zero is neither positive nor negative. So that is why we are writing with 1, 2, 3 and so on. And then next one, it is set of negative integers. So that is represented using z minus, which is equals to, so here we have so on minus 2 minus 1. So this is the set of negative integers. So this is all about the integers. Well, now we are going to discuss about types of natural numbers. In this we have even numbers, odd numbers, prime numbers and composite numbers. So let us start with the even numbers. Even numbers, even numbers 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 which are numbers which are multiples of which are multiples of 2 are called even numbers, are called even numbers. The numbers which are multiples of 2 are called even numbers. For example, 2, 4, 8 and so on. Next it is odd numbers. Numbers which are not multiples of 2, which are not multiples of 2, are called odd numbers. Example. So the example are 1, 3, 5 and so on. So all these are odd numbers. So next type, it is prime number. Prime number. So what is the prime number? A number which is divisible by 1 and itself is called a prime number. A number which is divisible by 1 and itself. A number which is divisible by 1 and itself is called a prime number. So example 2, 3, 5, 7. So 9 is not a prime number because 9 is divisible by 1 and itself, and it is also divisible by 3. That is why it is not a prime number. So then it is 11 and so on. So here 2 is the only even prime number. So that is the remark. Now 2 is the only even prime number. That means usually the prime numbers are the odd numbers except 2. So 2 is the only even prime number. So this is all about the even numbers, odd numbers and prime numbers. Well, next we are going to discuss about composite number. So what is the definition of a composite number now? A number which is divisible by the number other than 1 and itself is called the composite number. So for example, 4, 8, 9, 10, 20 and so on. These are all the composite numbers. So we will write the definition now. A number which is divisible by the number other than one and the number itself is called a composite number, is called a composite number. For example, 4 and then 6, 9, 15, then 20 and then so on. These are all the composite numbers. So pause the video to note it down.